The next topic is loading practices. The advantage of loading is not so great on open wire lines, which have an appreciable inductance of their own and so have such a distortion than cable. As a result, the practice of loading open wires has been abandoned. The loading practice is therefore normally restricted to cables only. Only for cables loading is applied. Basically, this loading practices happen in three ways. One is continuous loading, second one is patched loading, and the last one is lumped loading. Let us have a discussion on continuous loading. The figure shown here is a type of iron or some other magnetic material, and that is wound around the conductor to be loaded, thus increasing the permeability of the surrounding medium and thereby increasing the inductance. For this particular medium, it is wounded with some conductors. It is wounded. So that what happens? It increases the permeability of that surrounding medium, thereby it increases the inductance. This method can give an increase in inductance up to 65 millihenry per kilometer. But it is quite expensive due to laborious construction. Continuously it has to be wounded. Therefore it becomes very complicated. Further, the eddy currents and hysteresis losses in that magnetic material increases the primary constant resistance, R can also be increased. In addition, small difference in the mechanical treatment or pressure between the tape and conductor can cause large variations in the primary constants. So this is the precautions we have to take while designing. Therefore, continuous loading is used only on ocean cables, where the problem of making watertight joints at loading points renders lumped loading difficult. Furthermore, repair of a break in cable would normally result in alteration in the